Okay, team, we have a great topic for our eCYBERMISSION project. We think the rainwater is washing chemicals from the road into the local lake. And we want to test the water for those chemicals so we can educate the community about the problem. But does anyone know how we can get started answering the questions online?
No, not really. Maybe we should call Mission Control?
Yeah, good idea. Maybe they can help.
Mission Control, this is Nikki.
Hi. We have our topic, but we're having trouble answering the questions.
Say no more. We're on it.
But how do you know where I am?
Mission Control at your service.
Agent Nikki said you were curious about the questions.
Yeah. We've identified our project. We want to test the water in our local lake.
We think rain washes chemicals from the nearby road into our lake.
Well, that's a great project idea. Now, in order to turn that into a mission folder project, you need to figure out how to use a scientific method or the scientific inquiry to figure out a way to solve that problem.
Now, to use the scientific method or the scientific inquiry process means you need to develop a set of logical and rational questions in order to develop your conclusion.
Using the scientific method or a scientific inquiry helps to organize thoughts and procedures so that scientists can be confident in the answers they find. In both processes, you must pose a question or state a problem, conduct research, predict or hypothesize, test your hypothesis through experimentation, collect data, and draw conclusions.
Now you're all in luck because the mission folder questions follow almost the exact process that Josh is talking about.
That's right. The online questions cover 7 major areas. And the first is team collaboration. And this talks about how you work together as a team. It talks about how you assign tasks, shared responsibilities, and work together to solve your problem.
And the next step is your problem statement. Now, this is where you develop what problem you're trying to solve. So for you all, that will be the issues with your local lake. Do you all know what you would like to include in this section?
We could include what kind of toxic chemicals affect our lake or the history of our lake.
We could research what animals would be affected by the chemicals and how that would affect our town.
Great. The next step is by including this research, you will establish why this problem is so important for you to find a solution to. Don't forget in this step that you need to be sure to cite only scholarly sources.
And after the problem statement, you will need to answer questions focused on your hypothesis. Now, a hypothesis is just an educated guess about how things work. You can begin forming a hypothesis by setting it up in the following format. If I do this specific thing, then this specific thing will happen.
So our statement could be, if we add salt to fresh lake water, then all the plant life will die.
Exactly. And now that you've identified your problem statement, the next step is experimental design. Now in this step, you're going to want to make sure that you make a list of all of the materials that you used in your experiment.
So I could list our samples, a computer, measuring devices, and anything else we might use.
Yes, and during this time, you're also going to want to explain your experiment and include any variables that you identified.
After your experiment, your team will need to focus on data collection and analysis. This step is where you show your work by analyzing and interpreting the data you collected and observed in your experiments. In this step, you will determine whether your data supports or refutes your hypothesis.
Okay, but what happens if, after all of our experiments, we find out that we're totally wrong with our hypothesis?
This happens, and just because your hypothesis is wrong does not mean that your experiment is bad. Some scientists will have to conduct multiple experiments before they come to the correct solution.
Right. Now, the next 2 steps would be drawing your conclusions and how this would benefit your community. Now, if you were going to further continue your experimentation, you would need to describe that and how it would help solve your problem.
So our project wouldn't just end?
Not at all. In the real world, these are very important steps, and this would help you solve your problem.
Now, this is just a brief summary of the mission folder phases. We also recommend that while you're working on your project, you first will record all of your answers in something like a Word document. Then when you're ready and when everything has been proofread, you go back and copy and paste it into your mission folder only when it's ready to be submitted.
And remember, safety is very important. Never perform any experiments without the supervision of your team advisor. And always make sure to check with your team advisor to make sure your experiments are appropriate and allowed under the rules.
And remember, we at Mission Control are always just a phone call or an email away.
Thanks for all your help.
No problem.